Hello, anatomy colleagues. Welcome to station 18. And instead of talking about the sacrum and the coccyx, we'll leave that for the pelvic region. We're going to jump right into some of the joints, specifically the largest joints that are going to be associated with the vertebral column or your intervertebral joints. So recall that the intervertebral joints are going to be located between the bodies of most vertebrae. So it'll start, the most superior intervertebral joint will be between C2 and C3. So you'll have a disc there, and they will be found at every other level all the way down to L5, between L5 and S1. It will not be found between those immovable vertebrae for the rest of the sacrum and the coccyx. And recall, these are a type of symphysis, meaning that they are cartilaginous joints. So you'll have articular cartilage on the ends of the bone, and then you will have what we typically think of as the intervertebral disc between. And this will be composed of two layers. You will have the annulus fibrosis, which is what we can see here because it is the outer layer. We're not able to see the nucleus pulposus because that would be inside or in the inner portion of the intervertebral disc. But this annulus fibrosis is going to be composed of fibrocartilage. It is of the outer layer, so any outer layer is typically going to be the more protective layer. With the nucleus pulposus located on the inside, it is going to be that semi-fluid layer, which has the possibility of herniating through the annulus fibrosis that could cause impingement on spinal nerves that are exiting these regions. So that is the intervertebral disc. These aren't the only joints associated with the vertebral column. You will have articular facet joints kind of throughout. You can see one right here. But these are the only ones that we're going to have you identify on a practical setting. All right. Thank you for your time and attention here. And if you have any questions, please feel free to reach out.